with that. But I can tell you that the suit and the Bigfoot that you saw in that film was a hoax. Bob Hieronymus passed two lie detector tests, one performed live with Warner Brothers on a coast-to-coast television show, and passed both of them with flying colors. Now, if he's learned how to trick a lie detector test, it's totally beyond me. So we know that it was Bob Hieronymus in a suit shooting that film. And where did he get the suit? There was only a few places you could get the suit at that time in the world, and I was one of them, and at the price that Roger Patterson could afford. But let me continue with the short story about the one that we made for Circus World Museum. It's in the original cage that Ringling had for this gorilla, and there's a large line going through there. And just in front of me is a gentleman with his son, 5 or 6 years old. And they look at the gorilla, and the gorilla was we animated the gorilla so it would move slowly and look back and forth and so forth. And the son said to his father, he said, "Dad, is that gorilla alive?" And he said, "No, son, no, but it was at one time." That was the greatest compliment that I have ever received. Now, we end up making costumes for all types of movies, for television. David Copperfield, in fact, I spoke to David Copperfield on the phone here this evening. We're doing a special project for him. We made a gorilla suit for him. We're making another project, which I cannot talk about. But that's what we do. That's the nature of our business, and we're. So, I'm sorry. You go ahead and say what you need.
Thank you.
Go ahead. You got exactly one more minute there, Pat, before we go to MK.
All right. The other thing is the breasts and stuff. MK can go ahead. But OneStepBeyondReality.com stands 100% behind the movie, everything else that we're doing. It's coming out. When you see the footage that MK has got and the other things about it, there is no doubt in anybody's mind when they see it that is real, that Patterson did not fake it.
I got a question for you, Phil.
Sure.
When they asked you to do the reenactment for that TV, did you make the new costume that Hieronymus was in?
Yes, we did. Now, we had problems at that time of finding. See, Dynel was a fabric that was made in the United States, and since that time, as everything else, has moved to productions in China. National Geographic called us about 2.5 weeks before they're ready to shoot this thing, and was right at Halloween. That's our season. We are so busy. At Halloween time today, we are shipping anywhere from 10 to 15,000 packages a day out of here. And I actually took the time out and put together a suit for them, but it was impossible to find one the exact color. And then we had to go out and do some sculpture to match the face that Patterson had used. And then we had to do a chest to add the breast and so forth. So
did Bob actually do the actual same walk?
Yes. Bob was there.
In the suit.
Yeah. The whole film. It was an hour special, and half of it dealt with a swamp creature in West Virginia or something, and the other half was Bob, and Bob did the interview and told the same story just told you.
Incredible.
Let me ask you one question.
Sure.
These gentlemen are very credible in probably building suits. How could a cowboy end up putting breasts on an animal, supposedly an animal, that are so perfect and everything else, and move and everything else, which you'll see in the movie, and they couldn't put it together in a short length of time, and he got his costume in a short length of time,
he had the
everything onto it, and went from there? That's good.
Okay, he had the costume for several months. Roger was an artist. If you'll look at Greg's book, you can see some paintings and so forth that Roger had done. He was a sculptor. He had that ability. Again, it was a very low-tech suit. And I can tell you one funny story, and that is while we were out shooting the film, when we recreated this thing and added the breast to it for the shooting, the director came to me ahead of time, and he says, "Do the breast bounce?" And I said, "What are you talking about? Do the breast bounce?" He said, well, does the breast bounce when they walk? And I said, no, the breast doesn't bounce. It's they're fake. And he says, well, he said, when I looked at the Patterson film and slowed it down, he said, yeah, I could see the breast bounce. I said, well, they were full of baloney. I said, well, the breasts do not bounce. Now when Bob put the suit on and walked across the set, it appeared like the breasts were bouncing because the entire weight from those heavy breasts on, which is attached directly to the chest and the belly, and again, it is sewn into a suit that the back of it is just a knitted suit. They, as they moved, the entire chest, belly, and so forth moved, which gave you the illusion that the breast bounced. So and making breast, making that chest it was not a very difficult thing to do.
Thank you for that.
In the movie, when you go to the movie, there's a section on there that we show beyond a shadow of a doubt, and perhaps even MK could put it up tonight, but it shows something that, again, you've got to go and see the movie. No matter what, anybody can sit down, and then I'll relinquish my time, and I thank you very much. Anybody can sit down and say anything. I don't know if Patterson bought a costume or not. All I know, and everybody that has looked at the movie with me that is very knowledgeable, everybody tells me, even a few people in Hollywood, that there is nobody to this day that they know of, and we're talking about in 1967, build a suit that form-fitting and allow that much to come through. People have never seen the footage that we have in the movie. Has never been seen before. People do not understand or realize what this movie is about.
Well, thank you.
It's all thanks to M.K. Davis's ability.
Thank you for the compliment about building the suit. I appreciate it.
Well, we're going to get to the guy that he's talking about
right now.
Just put yourselves on mute six, both of you, please.
Okay.
And we'll get right back to you. Ladies and gentlemen, you heard Pat Holbrook come up with some good assumptions, and Phil Morris came right back at him. So we're going to they say you save the best for last. I hope we are. This is M.K. Davis. You've all heard about him. He's an amateur astronomer, devoted 10 years of his life dissecting the Patterson film through stabilizations and modern technology, and for the first time ever, he's going to reveal on our show here tonight, that's www.bigfootliveradioshow.com, the new starting evidence of why he believes that this is not a man in a gorilla suit. And I want everybody to understand this, that number one, Patty Patterson has given her permission to air these photos on our show through M.K. Davis. We got her permission. Out of no circumstances are anybody out there to download these things. They are copyrighted, and she's going to get very angry, and so I, as I will also, okay? So I want, ladies and gentlemen, out of Mississippi, we got M.K. Davis. You there?
Yes, I am.
Hey, buddy.
How you doing?
Well, you've heard it now for the last hour and 43 minutes, okay? You've heard the side on one side, and here we are. What do you got to say, M.K.?
Well, I'll tell you what, it sounds like a good story.
Okay.
You know, it's not a lot. I deal in images, not in rhetoric.
Okay, you know, so what we're saying now is, okay, you don't like to talk, but you want to prove yourself because of the pitches and the stabilizations that you've done. Is that what you're saying?
Well, yeah, I say the film should speak for itself, and I've always said that. You know, when I got into this 10 years ago, it was with that in mind, that if it turned out to be a hoax and I could pick it up, I would have no problem at all announcing that I had found a hoax. You know, I don't have any axes to grind or any agendas or anything like that, but what I have found has been quite the contrary.
Okay, fair enough. Why don't we do this? If everybody's there on www.bigfootliveradioshow.com, go down to halfway down, and you're going to see a Bigfoot. It says Bigfoot in the News with the glowing red eyes, and it says M.K. Davis presents new startling evidence why he believes this is not a man in a monkey suit. We've got number one, click for this link, and number two. Where do you want everybody to go, MK?
Well, right now, I know you're probably going to be mad at me, but right now I'm trying to send a quick image off to one of the people that were hosting my images, a good friend of mine named Rob Gaudet from Louisiana, as well as Jay Michael, who's hosting it on another site, Crypto Videography. But you know, when he mentioned about the interruption in the walk and it actually falling over, I didn't have that on the list, so I'm trying to see if maybe I can get it to Rob and he can get it up real quick. But that's just it's just a guess. It's fixing to when I get through sending this file, and then I can switch back over. Hold on.
Well, you guys heard it out there. He's trying to send something over to the webmasters to put it up so you guys can see this. Another new revelation that he's come up with.
Well, it came up in conversation, so you know, I'm trying to sort of tailor the images to what's being talked about, you know. So
I understand that, MK, but at the same point in time, you got to understand, I don't like to have dead time on my show.
I understand.
And you're not a guy that likes to talk; you like to show, and that's fine. So that's what I'm waiting. I'm trying to kill. I'm trying to stretch. It's what it's called in the industry.
Okay, now I've got my notes here. Let's see here. Breast made of leather. Well, let's address the rear end first, if we can. Number one, on the first link at the top of the, you know, where it's got under my name, is the first link, and it should take you to a page that says MK Davis at the top, Crypto Videography.
Okay, wait a minute, hold on. We go on to the number one where it says click on this link to see, right under where it says Gorilla Suit?
No. This should say cryptovideography.com/images154buttcrack.
Okay, hold on, wait a minute. Marco? Are you there?
Yes, I am.
Is he talking about the number one click or the number two click on our website?
The number one. It should be at the top.
It's on the number one, the original website. The second website is MK's other web. His
additional image.
Additional.
Okay, so, gentlemen, please, let's not play semantics on games. Is it number one right under the gorilla suit?
It's number one.
Okay, so I want the audience to make sure that there's no, it's a real easy way. Let's walk everybody through it. So right under where it says Gorilla Suit, ladies and gentlemen, it says number one, click onto this link, and that's where we're going, okay? All right, here we are. All right, now what do you want us to do, MK?
Well, it should say 154 butt crack, and just an illustration there. This was an image that was taken by Patterson when he was directly behind it.
Okay, so right on top, ladies and gentlemen, he's got it numbered to the left where it goes 1 to 26. We're going to hit number 1, Crypto Videography, Images 154 Butt Crack. Okay, so we're all on that now. Go ahead.
Okay, and Mr. Morris, in court of my notes, said that they stuffed a pillow up under the rear end.
Okay.
So I should have, let me go back, and I should have an animation that addresses that. It'll be number 9. It says glutes animation.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, go down to number 9. Like he said, glutes animation.
Now, it may take us a minute or so for this to load up for some people. Hopefully, they've already clicked on them and they have their little tracking cookies and stuff, so it'll load up quickly.
All right, so tell them what they're seeing right now.
Basically, what you're seeing is it's oscillating file. It's oscillating back and forth, and it shows the rear end, each side of the rear end, each cheek moving independently. I know, since I've been to the site, I don't know if you've ever been to the site, but it's in a deep canyon, and there's the canyon walls are lined with tall fir trees. And even in the